Hey guys, and welcome back to Guild Wars 2, to a brand new demo. Today we have the new Seven Reapers chest. Wasn't expecting a chest today, so that is exciting. In this chest we have the return of the blue dye canisters, which is also very exciting. I might be able to finish that off then, instead of selling them. I was kind of holding on to them. What even price are they at? How do I spell it? It's one N, not two N's. Oops. 125 for that one. Oof. So they would have been at like 2 gold like half an hour ago. Now they're not. I thought the reds were up higher. I guess not. Interesting. Maybe people think that they're going to come back now, so just selling everything. Anyway. We have the plasma weapons, we have the wandering cloud chair returning, we have the lunar maned skyscale, which looks pretty cool. And we have the seven reapers pauldrons, which also look pretty cool. Then we have fused weapons, we have the glyph of reaping, the glyph of timekeeper, we have... I think that's pretty much it. Mithril, Ghost Pepper, Lotus, and Snow Truffle are the nodes. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I guess it is time to dive in. Here we go. Now, we are going to start with 25. I might buy another 5. Or maybe a gold key at the end. We'll see. We got some die kits already. The Sacred Die Kit. Okay. Rare and valuable. Love it. We got it. The third key? Oh, fourth key? Fourth key. That's insane. What? And we also got a lovely solar lunar die kit and a guaranteed armor unlock from that. So that is awesome.
Rare and valuable.
It is rare and valuable. That's crazy good. That's a guaranteed wardrobe unlock and a crimson die kit there. What's that? Thunderhead? Bajora. Let's see what else we can get from these. Another sacred die kit. Ooh! A plasma shortbow. What's that? The blue shift. Very nice. Another sacred die kit. We're getting quite a few of those. Another crimson. Ooh! The pauldrons as well. What? Oh, this is going really well. This is probably one of my best,
Quite a reward.
What, I've opened 3 again since? As I was like... 15 keys for 3... rare or better drops. That's pretty good. We get another one to finish off the chest. Who knows? We have 3 more keys. We might get the cloud glider. That would be fantastic. One more key. Oh. We'll leave it at 25. We got the 3. Well, the 2 rare things that I really wanted to get. 2 of the 3. The only one I'm missing now is the cloud glider. But first off, let's do loot. Here we go. I can't wait till I can start selling some of this lunar stuff. Oh. First, we start off with the guaranteed weapon, which is the Sovereign Pillar. Okay, that is Festival, the 4 Winds, right? We got the Cavalier Axe and the Guild Cavalier Axe. Okay, that one there. We get the Golden Wing Sword from Codicus Manor, which I can't show off because I'm on Necromancer. We got the Butterfly Wings backpack, and we got the Simple Weaponsmith backpack. That's a really annoying one that I could have gotten easily. Oh, I keep doing that. I wish you could lock things in place. Let's do materials.
Now this is a fine.
Oh, we can get rid of those transmute charges, and that is all the materials we got today. Some ancient wood, some bones, some blood, some totems. One eltrite. Not too bad. Next up is the die kits. And we have the solar one here as well. Is that all the dyes? It is indeed. Okay. So we got the crimson lion dye, which is a very nice color. I think I use it on, might use it on Quando actually. Worth 425. Very nice. I'm gonna list it today. Got the brook dyes. 565 to 8. Okay, we'll list that one too. Honey dye. Worth 98. That's doesn't really matter. Lemon zest. A whole 2 extra silver. Okay, lemon zest. Very kind of a dark yellow there. Breeze. 22 copper. Pastel lemon looks a bit better than lemon zest, I think. A bit brighter. Red. 20 copper. Lemon ice. 19 copper. Banana. 9 copper. Blue ice. 9 copper. Citrus. 13. And strawberry. 26. Right, quick look at the plasma shortbow. It looks quite nice. I think I have this one already, so that is handy. And that is worth, at the moment, it's bound to fall, but 22 gold, and probably go down to like 18, 15, you know yourself. But now it's time for the Seven Reapers Pauldron. Ooh, these are cool with this color. Is there any other Seven Reapers? I feel like there is. There's the gloves. There are boots as well, no? Are you hot? No, that's it. Alright, here is the Seven Reapers Pauldrons paired with the gloves as well from a while back. They both have this aura, kind of black holy thing in the corners. And the spiny, grabby bits. Does it have a chain? It does have a chain on the shoulders as well as the gloves, okay. Let's have a look at the dyes for this. So default is very greeny. A very pale green, which looks very cool. Right, top left is the base of the shoulder. Top right is the kind of claws. There's top left again. Also has the chain on the top left. Top right from the side. And then bottom left is going to be kind of accents and stuff on the main body of the shoulders, just the secondary layer there. And bottom right is going to be the aura around that kind of black holy thing. That looks pretty cool. Just all black and orange, that looks awesome. Maybe a little bit of steel or something. Pretty cool. Right, next let's move on to the Lunar Maned Skyscale. Looks horrible in the colors I have. Oh, I'm already using it? I had this on Dark Monarch, it looks great. Lunar Maned, it looks horrible. Pretty cool. Let's see if it has a unique engage. Nope. Does it have a unique mount up? Kind of, yes. A unique dismount? Kind of, yes. I think that's unique. It looks unique. It is. Right, let's have a look at the default dyes for a little bit. Nope. Robin, white, cream, and iron. Yeah, There's a fire over here. What? Why is there a fire over here? But yeah, this looks pretty nice. Sounds great. Let's go check out the dyes. Here we go. Shadow Abyss. Everything. So you're always going to have the little white here, the red on the back. Other than that, it's all darkness. That's default. Right. That was two idols very fast together. Top left. Oh my god. It's going to be the main body, kind of the front of the legs, the wings, down the tail, little spots here as well. The horns. Oops. The horns. The crown. Back of the neck. Everywhere. Okay, top right is gonna be kind of the alternate side of the body, right? Yeah. Let's get down the cheeks, the sideburns, the back of the legs, the back of the wings, the back of the main body. There we are there. Also the ears, too. Bottom left is gonna be the belly and underside of the wings. As well as the underside of the tail, the pads of the paws, and some more of the cheek. And then bottom right is going to be, oh, that's around the eyes and the collar. Okay, so you have these are your three colors, four colors. That's how they all mesh together, I suppose. I don't know if that's helpful, but what can we make with this now? That's not too bad. I think there's too much of the midnight red. Very bright, very easily. I don't like the dyes. Pure white with like electro blue. There we go. White and electro blue. And like glint stuff, isolation and such. Or is it purview? I don't know. Right, there we have that. Finally, one last thing before we move on. And check out all the different characters and races. Is we have a brand new dagger. Let's go get that. Whoa, that's a lovely trail effect. Let's get somewhere flat. Here is the Ravensoul Dagger. Which looks very interesting. So the aura around it. And actually it works quite well with this blue that I've got going on. Very, very cool. So yeah, you have this lovely hilt with a raven head here, you have this gem in the middle, and you have this aura circling around it. Very, very cool. Right, let's go check out all the different races with the Skyscale and the dagger too at the same time. And then return to Quando to wrap up the video. Is that this? That's very loud. I've never had volume on while using those. Yeah, and then we'll return to Quando and wrap up the video. See you guys then. Right, here we are on a human with our brand new Skyscale, our maned Skyscale. This is, again, a blue, unintentional. I didn't know my human's Skyscale was dyed. This is a very similar fashion to what I just created. This is also a blue and light blue sort of dye channel. So on my human, we have Glint's purview. Yeah, we have Phthalo. Hello! We have Phthalo blue, we have Robin, and we have blue ice for the collar and everything. I know there's a chest over here Sergio showed me recently, and I don't remember. It's there? Or maybe it's this one, this waterfall here. Oh, there's one there, but that's not the right one. I found it. Look at me. Here is the dagger on a human as well. It's a bit of a darker area. Let's attack this thing. This wispy thing.
I feel good.
Kind of get a bit of a feel on how it will work in combat with regards just the trail effect. Will it be a lot? Will it be that sort of a sort of idea is what I'm trying to get at here.
All shiny.
Did I kill it? I killed it! Look at me. So yeah, that is it. The dagger on human looks a bit larger, obviously. Because a dagger for a human would be bigger than a dagger for an Asura. Here we are on another Necro, this time Charr. And the walk on Charr is so much better than the walk on Asura. Let me get into a clearing here. Why? No. Did I stumble on a Charr that just finished? So yeah, there it is on Charr. Very nice. Let's check out the Skyscale. This is a kind of black and red dye pattern. We're free! The sword went stowed, okay. Cool. So yeah, this is, Shadow Abyss, Amber, and Black Cherry. Which, on my usual Skyscale for this character, looks very good. It doesn't quite so much here. It looks pretty cool, but not as cool as it could. I would normally go for the Infernal one, right? Was it Incarnate or was it Branded? It was Branded. Incarnate would work too, though. Anyway, let's move on to our next character. Here we are on a Norn with the new daggers. Very, very nice. And here is the new Skyscale. Ooh, this looks weird. This dye pattern. What was that? I don't think the pink works. I think this is the Shimmer Wing. Yeah, I think I was using Shimmer Wing before. So that explains the pink. And it is. Here we go. Blue Rose, Frost Breeze, Persephone, and Robin. And finally, here we are on a Sylvari. Again, pinky with blacks and blues. I think pretty much every character had blues in it, didn't it? Oh well. So here we go. And this one is Shadow Abyss, Glory, Grape Gum, and Robin. Well, that's it from my character demos. Let's head back to Quando to wrap up the video. Overall, I think it's an alright Skyscale. It's not one I would go out of my way for, but it's alright. I prefer ones like I like the Dark Monarch. The Incarnate Flame's pretty cool too. I don't think I would go out of my way for this Lunar Maned Monarch. It's nice, but I wouldn't go out of my way for it. Right, let's head back to Quando to wrap up the video. Right, that is it for today's video, guys. I do hope you enjoyed. Leave a like if you did and subscribe for more in the future. You can check out this week's giveaway for your chance to either win the Skyscale, the Dagger, or Black Lion Keys. Whichever you prefer. And I'll be back tomorrow evening with some more Oblivion. Can't wait to return to that. Hopefully we can continue our save. If not, we might be starting again. Hopefully not. Oh, I don't know. We've changed modding. The mod loader. So. But yes, that is it from me for today. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more. Check out the giveaway if you'd like. Now you can join the Discord. You can join the community guild in Guild Wars 2. Either through the Discord or by messaging me in-game. And I'll be back later on the week with more. Until then, take care.